Yeah. Okay.
Should I start, sir?
Yeah, please start.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Saurabh Banerjee, senior resident from JIPMER. So I shall be presenting this case of echocardiographic diagnosis of ALCAPA in an infant with heart failure. So this was a 2-month-old female who had presented to us with symptoms of heart failure and failure to thrive. On echo, there was a dilated LV with ejection fraction of 32% and severe central MR. What was interesting was that papillary muscles were highly echogenic and they were thinned out. That is what probed us to see further. And on examining further, we found that the left coronary artery was found to arise from the pulmonary artery, and the right coronary artery was from the right coronary cusp. What was also found was that the right coronary artery was not dilated as normally found in ALCAPA cases, and there was a flow reversal in the left coronary artery. These are depicted in the echo images. So after this diagnosis, patient was taken over for surgical correction. And as we can see in the intraop picture, the diagnosis was confirmed. Left coronary artery was found to originate from the posterior pulmonary artery, and it was excised and then re-implanted into the aorta. So coming to the discussion, LV dysfunction is a common presentation for patients who have ALCAPA, and it is often an unrecognized cause. So any infant who presents with LV dysfunction, ALCAPA should be ruled out. The isolated right coronary artery dilatation may raise a suspicion, and RCA by aortic diameter of more than 0.2, this has been reported in some such studies to be helpful. So flow reversal in the LAD or in the left coronary artery into the pulmonary artery often clinches the diagnosis. And if we do not find this flow reversal, then some authors have used oxygen administration with FiO2 of around 100% for about 10 minutes to enhance this flow reversal. It is proposed that this causes a dilatation of the pulmonary artery, which promotes a flow reversal into the pulmonary artery. Abnormal collateralization can also be found in the interventricular septum, which was, however, not found in our case. So because this infant has had presented quite early on, around 2 months of age, so normal ALCAPA features like RCA dilatation and development of collaterals, these features were not found in this case. What we can conclude is that echocardiography is a good diagnostic tool for diagnosis of ALCAPA, and the harmful effects of radiation and of contrast may be avoided if we can utilize this modality judiciously, especially because these patients with heart failure are quite sick. And so if we
there are risks
associated with catheterization. So I think with advancement in echo, this can be a very good modality. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Dr. Saurabh.